orchestra to come forward so that we can start our program without any delay. So first of all, I request the chief guest and the speaker, Qadi Fadlullah Sahib, to kindly grace the chair with his presence, inshallah. If you kindly come here and sit down so that the people can see you, inshallah.
No, let them, I will.
Okay, all right. I can also see, if I'm not mistaken, Maulana Sahib over here from Darul Uloom.
Maulana Mikhail.
Maulana Mikhail, yeah. Mikhail, yes. I was just guessing that Maulana Mikhail is here. Welcome him. Inshallah, long ago he had come here and gave him khutbah. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban to Maulana Mikhail Sahib, inshallah. And first of all, I request Maulana Ajmal to kindly come here and recite a few verses with respect to the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا
سلام اس پر کے جس نے گالیاں سن کر دعائیں دی. سلام اس پر
Islamic University and got the highest degree in the Sharia law, postgraduate, and then he was elected to the National Assembly of Pakistan, has been the member of the parliament, and then he came to this part of the world, and he selected that part, this is the Los Angeles, California, and he has been serving in different centers, and he is very, very well-known Islamic speaker, multilingual Islamic speaker, he speaks English, Arabic, and Pashto, Urdu, and I hope Persian as well, right? Yeah, mashallah. And I will request him to kindly speak on the seer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially the relevance of the seer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the people living in this part of the world. Qadi Fadlullah.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما كان على النبي من حرج فيما فرض الله له سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله قدرا مقدورا الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله وكفى بالله حسيبا ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم وكان الله بكل شيء عليما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما. تحيتهم يوم يلقونه سلام وأعد لهم أجرا كريما. يا أيها النبي إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا وبشر المؤمنين بأن لهم من الله فضلا كبيرا. صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم. Distinguished Ulama, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all, I would like to pay thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave me this ample and golden opportunity to meet you brothers here in this beautiful masjid and house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in connection to Siratul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then I would like to pay thanks to all of you that you came. You are sitting here after Salatul Maghrib listening to Deen and to the Seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers, Seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the source of Sharia. Because there are two things. One is the Holy Book and the Holy Quran. And second is the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the source of Sunnah. What he said, what he did, what he approved, what he confirmed, that is considered the basic two sources of Islamic law. My dear respected brothers, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only as a preface, I would like to say that Islam is not the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is not the deen of this ummah alone or only. Originally and basically that is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah said, inna deena indallahi al-Islam. Deen in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. Then, Islam is the deen of all the prophets. It started with Prophet Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, processed towards its completion and perfection through all the messengers of Allah, completed and perfected in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are with his message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليه وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء وَيَعْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. We have given you the same deen, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same sharia, O Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which we had given before you to Nuh, to Musa, and to Isa. And our message to all of them was to keep it in its upright position. Do not make it crooked. Do not make a pick and choose in the deen of Allah. That's a package. Take it or leave it. Because deen, as far as acceptance is concerned, you have to believe it from A to Z. As far as practice is concerned, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in one of his hadiths, مَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ وَأَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Whatsoever I have forbidden, stop. Abstain from. There is no any loophole, no any gray area as far as prohibition is concerned. وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Whatsoever I have commanded you, I have ordered you to do and to practice, so do as much as you can do. Because he has ordered a lot of things, but because of our shortcomings, our weaknesses, our faults, our defaults as well, we are unable to do all of that. So here, because of his mercy, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَاتُوا مِنْهُ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Do it as much as you can. In Surah Al-Hashr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whatsoever the messenger has given you in his word, in his actions, in his sanctions. Because when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw a Muslim doing something, and he didn't say any reaction to it. So it means that he confirmed that action. We call it Taqreer Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we define the hadith in a general sense. قول الرسول وفعله وتقريره. That is the word of the Prophet, or the speech and the speaking of the Prophet. That is the actions and practices of the Prophet. And that is the sanction of the Prophet. And let me add another thing today. I've written one of my book in Arabic language, in Usul al-Hadith, by the name of Dirayat al-Riwayah. That a hadith, these are of four types. The words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the actions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sanctions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that what the ulama have done. They have talked about the fourth, but they have not made it a fourth type of hadith. Let us not say it. So I made it in the very first division, and that is called al hadith al hukmi. And what is al hadith al hukmi? Sheikh Mikael is here. Yes, and Sheikh Al-Jawab, he is here. And Qadi Sahib is here. So they will let me out. Did anything which a human through his akal and sense cannot avail. He couldn't know if a Sahabi said such a thing which is regarding Qabr or Maghribah, that is regarding Akhirah and Qiyamah. Now what will be happening at the Day of Judgment? Only that one can know who has been informed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the science does not know about that anything. What will be going on in Qabr? The scientific research cannot tell you anything. But when a Sahabi says something like that, are maqadir figures. Regarding something, they go what? The figures. So you cannot put figures from your own. For sure, you have heard it from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one way or the other. So we call it Hadith al-Hukmi. that even though the Sahabi has not attributed the same to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but still that is the same Aqeedah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the Aqal of human does not know that. So anyhow, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatsoever the Messenger of Allah has given you in words, in actions, in sanctions, or as I said, the fourth category, فَخُذُوهُ, hold it firmly. فَخُذُوهُ, what did it mean? Hold it firmly. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ, and whatsoever He has forbidden you from, فَانْتَهُ, abstain from. Now, if somebody will say like this, then who knows? Who knows? Oh brother, the whole Ummah knows. Who knows? The whole Ummah knows. Who knows? Oh brother, all the Sahaba know. Who knows? All the Tabi'in knew that. Who knows? All the Atba'u Tabi'in knew that. Who knows? All the Ulama and the general public in their lifelong history, they knew that. That Prophet ﷺ said, he practiced, he sanctified. Because he was a living entity. Or we can say a perfect living entity. Or a perfect living personality. So you are a living entity. You say or not? Say. You speak or not? All of us, we speak. You act or not? You approve and disapprove or not? You do. Prophet was doing the same. But there is a big difference. You are a common layman. Prophet ﷺ was a prophet. You are a common layman. He was a source of Sharia. You are a common layman. He was a role model. Not in his saying and actions, in his personality, he was a role model. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Holy Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Didn't say, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي أَقْوَالِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. في أفعال رسول الله أسوة حسنة. في تقريرات رسول الله أسوة حسنة. What he said? في رسول الله, his personality. Look at him. That's what the Sahaba were doing. How they learned? They used to look at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's what he does. He said, they were sitting, trying to sit like him. They were standing, trying to stand like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. They were eating, looking at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he eats, how he drinks. Now that is for academic purpose, that we say and we make the classification that sunan are of two types. One is called a sunan al-adiyah. The second one is called a sunan al-adiyah. That's a fiqh issue. That's what? That's a fiqh issue for academic purpose. As far as the practice is concerned, so regarding practice, Sunan-e-Ibadiyya, that is the practice of the Prophet. Sunan-e-Adiyya, that is the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know what I am saying? But now, regarding Sunan-e-Ibadiyya, he said, do it. Regarding Sunan-e-Adiyya, he did it in his usual life. Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim al-Na'im, they recorded it. They preserved it. And they transferred it to the coming generation. Imam Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayh, he has written a specific book. One is his famous book, the big one, Shamail al-Tirmidhi, Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Shamail al-Tirmidhi is not a part of Sunan al-Tirmidhi, even though they combined now together. But Shamail al-Tirmidhi is a different book. That's a separate book of Imam Abu Isa al-Tirmidhi. That is regarding the surah and the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Sahaba al-Islam, they were looking at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How was his complexion? How were his cheeks? How was his forehead? How was his head? How was his hair? How was his beard? How were his teeth? How he was speaking? How was his lips? How was his chin? Everything they are mentioning here. How was his dress? How was his shirt? How was his shoe? How he was walking? How he was sitting? Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala an, he narrates a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, izama sha ka annama ينحط من سبب. When he was walking, ينحط من سبب. When you are coming down over his feet. Yeah. So what you do at that time? Number one, you put your foot very firmly, not to step. Yes. Number two, you are looking at the ground. Yes or not? So when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was going, he was putting his feet very firmly, and he was looking at the ground because of tawazu, because he was the utmost humble person in the creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is said that in alamul arwah, Ibn Abbas said, in alamul arwah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the ruh of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, that who are you? What's your introduction? So he said, Safiyullah, the chosen one by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He asked the ruh of Nuh, Manant, who are you? He said, Najiyullah, the one who got rescued by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's in decreed already, later on physical world he will have it. Got it? So something which is decreed by Allah, that is as firm and certain as something has been done in the past, and you cannot undo it. Because that is done. And that was saying now inside, you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
All the brothers, please, for the sake of Allah subhanahu, I am focusing on you. Chishma manda, chishma tu, chishma ni tu jaye digar. Manta mashayi tu kardam tu ta mashayi digar. When I am focusing on you and looking at you, you should look at us, look at me. Not look at my face, I am not that much handsome. Or let's see, I am not that much pretty. But anyhow, still, I am a human. I am a student of Quran and Sunnah. Look at what I am saying. Because sometimes the body language means a lot. Yes or not? Yes or not?
Yes.
Jazakallah. Because I want your response also. Yes?
Yes.
You speak good. Too much eloquent. Yes? With loud voice you can say it. So anyhow, my dear respected brother of Islam. So Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala an, he said, Kanama in Hatum and Sababin. He was walking like that. So I was referring to Alamul Arwah, that Nuh alayhi salatu was salam said to Nabiullah. Allah asked Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam, wa man ant? So he said, Khalilullah, the friend of Allah. These are their titles. Ismail was asked, Zabihullah, the one who is slaughtered in the path of Allah, mean being done, even though it will be happening later on. But as I mentioned, as certain as something which is done in the past, as Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu was salam, when he was a newborn baby, he was born without father. Sayyidina Maryam, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, she brought him, فَأَدَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُ قَالِ يَا مَرْيَمُ لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا. What a bad thing you have done, O Maryam. مَا كَانَ أَبُوكِ امْرَأَ سَوْءٍ وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيًّا. Your father was not a bad man. Your mother was a very chaste woman. Where from this unchastity? Because you are not a married woman. As she was inspired already by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِمَّا تَغَيِّنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا فَقُولِي إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. That if you will see any human, so for sure, he will be asking you, you are not a married girl, where from you brought this baby? فَإِمَّا تَرَيْنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا فَقُولِي إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. Yes, so tell them that I have called to Rahman, the beneficent one, to do fasting. And at that time, Sawm Nazar includes not to speak even. There was a common fasting which is not to eat, not to drink, and the third thing, you know, इंसानों के तो जोड़ी हो तो हैवान की भी समझ में आती है बहुत जल्द, क्योंकि वो नेचुरल प्रैक्टिस है. सो एनीहाउ उसने कहा कि इन्नी नज़रतु लिर्रहमान सौमन फलन उकल्लिम अल्यौम इंसिया. सो नोबडी शुड ट्राई टू स्पीक टू मी दिस डे. सो एट दैट टाइम व्हेन समबडी प्लेजिंग टू अल्लाह सुभानहु व तआला, वर्ड टू अल्लाह सुभानहु व तआला, दैट आई विल फास्ट इन सच एंड सच डे फॉर द गुड प्लेजर ऑफ अल्लाह, that is called nazar, which is practically wajib for us, that is like all other songs, like all other fasting in the month of Ramadan. Got it? But for them, it was including not to speak even. As you know, the different tasawwurat and concepts are there. Yesterday it was Shabbat. Yes? So you can ask the Kufi guys that what Shabbat mean. So they will tell you that what Shabbat mean. Yes, at daytime and at night time. Anyhow, that's something else you should go ahead. So إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. So when they said to her, أَنَّا لَكِ هَذَا, where from you got it? Our baby, without a father, you are not a very girl. مَا كَانَ أَمُكِمْ رَأَصَوْمًا, your father was not more forbidden even. وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيًّا, and your mother was not an unjust woman. So genes are very favorable. Genes are very tayyibu. Where from this unchastisement? Where from this impurity? For Ashar, she indicated to the newborn baby, قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا. I've written a book on this, Jesus in Holy Quran, in the babe, these brothers, they are working on these books, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. Whatever I am teaching them, and I'm writing, giving it to them, they do compose it, and they do print it. When we are going somewhere, so we put it there. Let me tell you one thing. I have nothing to do with the books. I have nothing to do with the money of the books. And even they are spending their own money. But as you know, that we are not Bill Gates and not Warren Buffett. Yes? If we will break their treasury, in one way or the other. In one way or the other, mean if they will bless us well. In one way or the other, does it mean that we are going here with clash and go there, give us? Yes? We are not from Tahor. Yes, anyhow, my dear respected brothers in Islam, قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا. We have nothing to do with single dollar of these books. Whatever is coming, we are giving it to other books. And I am touching on these burning issues. And the brothers, sometimes they ask me, why this? I say, somebody has to come forward. Somebody has to come forward to remove the smoke and the smog and to tell and speak the truth. That's what the reality is. So I wrote a book. As you know, when you will listen to the media, electronic media, sometimes they speak the anchors, Sharia law. Sharia, so they say, what's Sharia? And my brother, he said Sharia and law. So Sharia law. Got it? So I wrote a book, Sharia in Politics. Purposely, I did not mention Islam in politics or Islam in politics. Because Sharia has been condemned by these ignorant people. So that's why I named the book as Sharia in Politics. Sharia in Politics. That is number one. Number two, regarding Sayyida Aisha, Raziyallahu ta'ala anha, and her marriage, which is a burning issue, I don't know here, but everywhere, and especially in California. On the beach, they are standing, having the megaphone, and saying things against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Only this one issue. Got it? So somebody wants to come forward and to say that what the real story is. What the real? So I wrote a book, Sayyida Aisha, Age and Marriage. Sayyida Aisha, Age and Marriage. And also about Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam. So I wrote a book, Jesus in Holy Quran. Jesus in Holy Quran. And tell you one thing, yes, but we don't have a copy. I think we have only one copy. So somebody got it yesterday in the room. Somebody got it. That is too much burning issue. Jihad, what, why, and when? Jihad, what, even though, I'm sorry to say, with the mullahs and the shuyukh, yes, we are very much afraid of. We skip it. We jump for jihad. When we come to that, we jump for it. Oh, terrorism. Oh, brother, those who are propagandists, still they do not know what terrorism is and who's terrorism. They cannot define it. They have not defined it yet. Other definition, as you know, that that's a universal issue. So there must be a definition to a term which is understood and recognized universally. Otherwise, I will call you terrorist and he will call you terrorist and they will call you terrorist and everybody will become terrorist and this will be terrorism. Yeah, so it doesn't mean, after 9/11, we used to go to synagogues, to churches, to schools, to colleges, to universities, and sometimes we are thankful to them, they used to invite us and we were giving them beer and talking about the issue, because situation at that time was very tense. Got it? So as you know, I have a black turban. And Sheikh Pikai, Jazahullah, he has a black turban. And my two brothers who are with me, they are traveling with me all the time, anywhere when I am going, they have the two black turbans as well. Yes. So when we went to one big church, a lot of people were there. So then I said that first of all, I want to clear your doubt. I want to clear your doubt. This turban of mine or beard of mine, these are not two shahideen or witnesses of terrorism or two groups of terrorism. That I have the turban or I have the beard, it means that you are a terrorist. I say, same like the scarf of a lady is not a symbol and sign of terrorism. Otherwise, I was entering to your church, so I saw two statues. One was that of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, and the other one was that of Virgin Mary. Yes, so I said that Isa, he had a beard. Yes, and Virgin Mary, she had a scarf. So if that is the case, so you have put two terrorists right in front of your church. Got it? So anyhow, my dear respected brothers in Islam, I was referring to that we have to speak out the truth. This is our country. We are here. Yes, you want to go back to your own country? If anybody wants to go, so he should raise his hand. And if somebody will raise his hand, yes, when he will go back home. Yes, so the home minister, if you are going, just go. I am not going. If you are going, just go. I am not going there. So when you are here, so don't live in fear. Don't live. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith, La yajitaka khawfan fi qalbi mu'min. In the heart of a woman, two fears will never get together. A woman will be having either fear of Allah or fear of makhluk and creature. So if you say that I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should not have fear of anybody else. If you are not doing anything wrong, where from the fear came? Why the fear is holding you? Be proud of your deen. Be proud of your deen in culture as well. God in Islam is, you are not proud of your own deen and faith and belief, it means that you do not have it perfectly. Otherwise, you would have been proud of them. That Alhamdulillah, I am Muslim. Alhamdulillah, I am Muslim. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers, Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the small baby, the cradle, فَأَشَارَ إِلَيْهِ She indicated to قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا He's a newborn baby in the cradle. How you are indicated towards the newborn baby? How we can speak? Because he doesn't understand. If he understood, he cannot answer. So Isa al-Islam himself, he spoke out. قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ He said, I am the slave of Allah. And look, regarding Isa al-Islam, whenever his words is narrated by Allah, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said, Inni Abdullah, I am the slave of Allah. Because Allah was very much aware of. And he inspired Jesus alayhi salatu wa salam that later on people will come, they will call you Lord, so make it clear from now that I am Abdullah. Inna Allah Rabbi, wa Rabbukum fa'budu, hadha salatu mustaqeem. I am not the Lord of anybody. My Lord and your Lord is Allah. So qala Inni Abdullah, aatani yaki. My brother, Shaykh Abdul Jabbar, Qadir Sahib, Shaykh Bikai, and maybe some other brother also, I don't know, but they know Arabic language very. So, Aatani ya kitab, Aata yuti kitab. So, Aata, this is past tense, or fail in mazi, Aatani ya kitab. It means that he has given me the book. Yet, he had not attained the age of liberty. Yet, he had not become adult enough to receive the book or to be the messenger But he used the past tense. Literal meaning is Atan Yadkitab. So Imam Qutb Mufassirin, they said that when Fa'il Maziyah, past tense is used for something in future, so it gives the concept of certainty. That Atan Yadkitab, Yudhir Kitab Yatinan Bakatan. He will be giving me the book in the future for sure. And I said, no. Just leave the word as it is. Atan Yadkitab. He has given me the book because it is already decreed. وَكَانَ أَمْرُ رَهِبْ قَدَرَ مَقْدُورًا وَكَانَ أَمْرًا مَقْدِيرًا. Got it? So let's go back. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. So Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam said, Khalilullah. The Ruha of Ismail said, Zabihullah, I would be slaughtered. I am a Zabiha of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Ruha of Musa said, Kareemullah. Yes, the one who is speaking to Allah, Allah will speak to him. And Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, Ruhullah. Now all these titles are very much respected and honored titles. And they said it. They said it. But our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how many titles he has? Numerous. Got it? But he did not mention any title of him. He did not mention any title of him. The greatest title for a slave is to be slave of the master. So he was asked for man anta ya Muhammad, qala ana abdullah. I am the servant of Allah. I am the slave of Allah. So that is such a greatest title. No other title can compete it. Qala inni abdul. Otherwise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given that much respect. Look at me. That much respect. That all the messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them by name in Holy Quran when he is narrating their story. Ya Adamu, uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah. O Adam, live you, reside you along with your wife in Jannah. Along with your wife in Jannah. Ya Adamu, uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah. Imam Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, he was referring to the ayah. So he said that boarding, lodging, maintenance, protection, defense, everything, that's on the shoulders of the husband. That's not true. So Imam Abu Yusuf asked him, Shaykh, do we have anything in the Quran in this regard? He said, so many. But let me start it with us, alayhi salatu wa salam. Then Allah was supposed to say that uskuna al-jannah. Dual. Tasniyah. You and your wife both. Uskuna al-Jannah, live in Jannah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Uskun anta, you, wazawjuka, and your wife. You, and your wife. So Imam Rahmatullah said, a few concepts are there. A few, they, that is the duty of the husband to provide the provision, all the needs and the necessities. Yes, the residence, the living, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, what type of living you are bound to give to your wife or provide to your family? Allah says, Askinuhunna min haythu sakantum min wujdikum. Shaykh Mikhail? Yes. In California, we are reading this Quran. Yes, what Quran is here in India? The same one. So in that Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Askinuhunna min haythu sakantum min wujdikum. Askinuhunna. Put them in such a residence. Provide them such a living. Where you are living. Number one, Imam Rahmatullah said that husband and wife, that is must for them to live together. If they don't have any excuse. Sometimes the excuse is that the job is there and he cannot afford a second residence there. Yes? So that's something else. But basically, they have to live together. أَسْكِنُوهُنَّ مِنْ حَيْسُ سَكَنْتُمْ مِنْ وُجْدِكُمْ. What is wujd? وَسَعْتُ وَالْقُوَّةِ. وَسَعْتُ وَالْقُوَّةِ. To the best of your capability. To the best of your financial sources and resources. So now if somebody can provide his family a beautiful house. What? A beautiful house and he is taking them to a dirty apartment. Yes, and he is getting the money. What is the use of this money? That is useless money. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, and hadith is Qudsi. And Qudsi hadith, where implicitly or expressly Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam attributed the same to Allah subhanahu. Otherwise all that what he said he got inspired by Allah. When this be is hawa ma zalla sahibukum wa hawa wa ma yantiqu an al hawa in huwa illa wahyu yuha. So I said to the brothers in Dars that one najm is a hawa, that this najm is serious, not an ajm in general. This story, the serious. They said, any support? I said, the same surah. وَأَنَّهُ غَرْبُ شِعْرَىٰ That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a lot of serious. And their project in Abbas says, their specific lives, they used to worship the serious. So one najm is a hawa, hawa mana sakata. And how our mana wow, and how our mana nazula. So a najm is a hawa. Allah is giving in this one sentence a few messages to the people of Arabia. That what time of God they gave, now you are shining here, now disappear. Qalini la uhibbu lafilin. Ibrahim said, I don't like prophets who disappear. I'm looking for a God who is there 24/7. Our Allah is there 24/7. Now I have written a book. Does God exist? They are working on it. Does God exist? This is another problem. This telephone technology is good. My friend Dr. Abdullah Aziz, he is asking me again and again, every time, Sheikh, why you are not keeping a telephone? I said, because this cellular phone is sometime like it was 2IC to center, second in command. But now it has overtaken center. Yes, and I made a joke last night. There's some brother, you know, Sheikh Pika, he said, Sheikh, why you don't have the telephone, the cellular phone? I said, because I'm trying to hide from my wife. When you have it, she can find your location. When you don't have it, yeah, just go ahead and enjoy your life. So, one day, Mira Hawa, Mazan Sahibukum Huma Hawa, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, this is the azab, this telephone, but you cannot stop the technology. Nature is evolutionary. And evolution will be taking place. New technology will be coming to existence. You can, yes, you can only make it use good. You can make one, otherwise, this cell phone destroyed so many families and their respect and their honor. Really? Yes, I'm right. Now, you cannot stop your kids if you will say that let me put them in the cabinet. So what you will do is send your son and daughter inside the cabinet. They will be staying there forever. You cannot hold them. Yes, the only thing is just have sitting with them, talking to them about your culture, Islamic culture, about your being, to make up their minds. I have my small grandkids. So I'm talking to them even though they do not know much more about that. But sometimes I talk to them. Look, my son, I am going to the house of Allah. And I am going to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And just make dua. So they say, where is that? I said that in Makkah. And that is in Medina. Yes. So one of my grandkids, he said that Makkah is the big brother of Medina. I said, yes, that's the big brother of Medina. And Medina is the small brother of Makkah. Yes. He said, I want to see them. So I said, okay, I will take you. Thank you. Yes, another grandkid of mine, my wife told him, my father, that let's go to the house of Allah subhanahu. So he asked her that Allah is there? Allah is there? So she said, yes, Allah is there, let's go. So when she brought her to the masjid, I was giving khutbah. My kids, they are calling me Khanji. Yes, so I was giving khutbah. So he said to my wife, but Allah is not there, this is how you is speaking. But you have to put all these things, yes, to print it on their cells and in their brain. Later on they will come to know. Yesterday, I was sent here in the room that when we were small students, of Deen, so as you know, we start with small books of Surah An-Nahl.
Yes.
We do. So at that time we were memorizing Surah Mir. Memorizing? That was in Persian language. We did not have at that time that much Umarasa in Persian language. Later on, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with, but at that time not. And Surah Mir was in Persian language. So you are memorizing. And our Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayhi is going to tell us that you have to repeat this sabak of yours today 100 times. So what you are doing? From this word to this word, and from this one to this one in tasbih. Tasbih. And you are saying, Nasrallah asal nasran kudo nasran sila mazdar kudo jo fatman kisila mazdar ka sila wahid mazdar wahid firmanji maalum saazan da har fe bol basal islam mufti par har kudo nasran do maqam da akhir ma fatkhada rando tamir mazdar ila hazam kar dand and tamir amalatul ismu al fayla kar amalatul ismu dana sam gash nasara shudo and then you are saying nasran 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 dana sam. So I was telling the students here in Darul Uloom, that one Baba, they used to take a schedule sent in the morning to the farm for grazing. So once after our Asr prayer, he came and he said to our Shaykh, to our teacher, that Maulvi Sahib, he said, yes. He said, these few students, every day when I am going, so they are walking from this one to that one, and that one to that one, and barking like dogs. What they are doing? That they are barking like dogs. And if you do not understand the sound, and the meaning and the sense. So to you, that is nothing more than barking. So he said, these students are barking like dogs. So anyhow, later on, when we understood all these things, we said, what a beautiful thing it was. It provided us it. So Shaykh, he printed it on ourselves in our brain, and later on we understood it. Then you have to do with your small kids. They do not understand what is Deen, what is Allah, what is Kalima, but say, Allah, I have a very small grandkids. Yes, very small. All these students, they are in love with him. He's very lovely and he's very active. Yes, so, as you know, that we the Muslims, when we sneeze, so we say, Alhamdulillah. We say, Alhamdulillah. And we answer, Ya Alhamdulillah. So, Alhamdulillah. When any one of us, even he coughs, or she coughs, yeah, so he cannot speak properly, but he hamdra. He said, hamdra. And in anger, that's why we did not say alhamdulillah. Because for coughing, we don't say it. Yes, but he cannot differentiate between coughing and sneezing. So when he coughs, he said, hamdra. So he said, alhamdulillah. Yes, so now what? Later on, he will come to know what it means. Got it? Otherwise, you cannot guide them properly. This is a lengthy process. Deen is not such a thing that you will do it for a while and you will be graduated. وَعَبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَاتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. This procedure will be going on until your death. So my dear respected brothers in Islam, anyhow, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. And tell you one thing else. Sometimes the brothers, they do ask me, I am not going to make our claims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, huwa a'lamu bikum iz anshaakum min al-ardh wa iz antum ajinnatun fi butun ummahatikum fala tuzakku anfusakum huwa a'lamu biman ittaqa. They don't make our claims. I told them that not literally, but technical meaning of Allah tuzakku anfusakum means don't make tall claims. Fala tuzakku. I'm like this. I do like this. This I, one of the Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayhi, he used to say that never use the word I or me. In Urdu language, what? Me. In Pashto, Zor. Ya ma. Mukhadri maan or what? Par he said, Mukhadri maan or what? Everybody is making claim. Maan last. I did it. I did it. I have done it. Me ne sakar di. Me, me. Et saan kitabe bohut likta. उसकी एक किताब एक तालीम याफ्त आदमी उठा के ले आया रशियन तफसीर मौलाना अहमद अली लाहौर रहमतुल्लाह अलैह के पास कि हजरत ये एक साहब हैं अच्छी किताबें लिखता है तो आपका क्या ख्याल है. आपका क्या? रशियन ने किताब उठा लिया. शेर ने किताब के दो तीन सफ़े देख लिए. उसने कहा कि बेटे बस जब तक आपको प्रॉपर इल्म दीन का न हो ये न होता. तो उसने कहा कि जी वो तो बहुत अच्छा बोल रहा है, बहुत अच्छा लिखता है. उसने कहा आपने मुझसे पूछा तो मैंने आपको मुखलिसाना मशवरा दिया. तो उसने कहा जी किताब में क्या खराबी है? तब ये बात सुनने की हूँ कि किताब में क्या खराबी है. अगर शेख तफसीर मौलाना ने फरमाया कि बाकी खराबियां तो अगर मैं आपको बताऊं भी वो आपके जहन में आने वाली नहीं. क्योंकि वो आपके रिपोर्ट से बहुत हाई है, सही। लेकिन सबसे बड़ी खराबी ये है कि मैंने 3 सफे देख लिए और 9 बार इस आदमी ने, लेकिन मैं ये कहता और मैं ये कहता और मेरा क्या, उसने कहा ये मैं का शैतान जिसमें घुस जाए वो बाद में बड़ा फितना बन जाता है। And this happens, we have observed it.
Yes, Maulana Zakir Sahib.
हमारे बड़े उलमा वो कभी नहीं कहते कि मैं ये कहता हूँ, वो अगर अपनी राय भी चला वो कहता हमारा ख्याल ये है, सही। एंड दे से मैन ए सेफ साउंड प्रोटेक्शन फॉर यू एज वेल व्हेन यू विल यूज अ प्लूरल इट मींस यू आर गिविंग अ मैसेज दैट इन दिस ओपिनियन आई एम नॉट हैविंग माय ओन और आई एम नॉट अलोन। शेख इस्माइल इज विद मी, शेख मिकाइल इज विद मी, एंड व्हेन मिकाइल इज विद समवन ही इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग द मैसेज व्हाट ही इज थिंकिंग अबाउट। सो इन हाउ माय डियर रिस्पेक्टेड ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर, My dearest respected brother in Islam, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. I have written a book in Usul al-Fiqh in Arabic language. So there I have mentioned it in the very beginning and starting chapters. I have mentioned here that the action, this word, the sanctions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is source of law. Yeah, but the silence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or the not doing of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is source of law or not. So there are two opinions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say anything about a specific thing. What will be its position in Sharia? So mostly the jurisprudence of ulama, they have not discussed it in detail. Yes, we tried to discuss it that in detail and then providing it a support, that this is the support that when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not affirm or did not negate a specific thing, so its position will be that of mubah. لأن الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi says, جمهور سے امام مالک امام شافعی احمد بن حنبل رحمہ اللہ I was starting to book in fiqh also regarding to our four school of the students because I'm teaching that to the students so that's why at the same time I'm trying to write it in two different languages in Arabic and also in English so and just make dua may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfeeq as much as we can do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so my dear respected brothers in Islam Imam Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi says الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة ولكن ليس الأصل في الأفعال كلها الإباحة. تین علماء کا مسلک تو یہ ہے کہ اصل اشیاء میں یہ کی جائز پرمیسیبل خدا خدا کا مرفی قبل جمعی آئے امام ابو حنیفہ رحمۃ اللہ علیہ فرماتے ہیں کہ تینز کے حوالے سے تو یہ صحیح ہے ایکشنز کے حوالے سے یہ رول جنرل نہیں ہے شیخ بگاری تینز کے حوالے سے تو یہ جنرل ہے لیکن ایکشنز کے حوالے سے ये जनरल नहीं है, एक्सेप्शन है। उसने कहा इबादत को तो ये कायदा अप्लाई नहीं होता है इबादत। और मैंने एक किताब लिखी है मसाइल अरबा में अलकवायद अलफकिया, अलकवायद अलफकिया तो वहां पे इस पे डिस्कशन की है कि इमाम क्यों ये कहता है और जमहूर भी कहते हैं। तो इमाम रहमतुल्लाह अलैह फरमाते हैं कि इबादत ये उमूर तअब्बुदिया है। हम नमाज क्यों पढ़ते हैं? इसलिए कि अल्लाह का हुक्म। हम रोजे क्यों रखते हैं? बताएं, अल्लाह का हुक्म है। हम हज पे क्यों जाते हैं? अल्लाह का हुक्म है। हम ज़कात क्यों देते हैं? अल्लाह। हाँ, हिकमत उसमें जरूर होगी। लेना फारुल हकीम ला तखदुर अल हिकमा। अरबी का एक मक़ूला है कि हकीम और वाइज मैन की कोई बात भी हिकमत से खाली नहीं होती, वो ओल्ड फोल्ड नहीं बचता, वो ऊट पठान बातें नहीं करता, फिर अल्लाह करीम उसकी तो ज़ाती सुन کہ وہ تو حکیم و علیم ہے۔ تو امام رحمۃ اللہ علیہ فرماتے ہیں کہ عبادات میں امور تعبدیہ ہیں، امور تعبدیہ آرڈر آ گیا پھر راست لگائے۔ آپ جھکتے کیوں ہیں؟ اللہ نے کہا اور کون مرنا چاہیے۔ آپ سجدہ کیوں کرتے ہیں؟ اللہ نے کر دیا سجدہ کہ اللہ کے لیے سجدہ کرو۔ البتہ امام فرماتے ہیں کہ باقی افعال میں اصل اباحت ہے، اور اگر شریعہ نے پروہیبٹ کر دیا تو پھر وہ حرام ہو جاتا ہے۔ امام علی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ اس نے اپنی معرفت العلیٰ کتاب حجۃ اللہ البالغہ उसी ने बड़ी अजीब बात की कल्चर ऑफ अरेबियन पीपल इन थ्री कैटेगरीज their customs, their usages, their rusum, their al-mija, their adab, their habits into three categories. So the first one, which was totally okay, nothing was wrong with their custom and their practice and usage of them. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam endorsed it. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he kept it as, like as you are selling your car, as. Got it? You put quote and quote what? Is. Prophet kept it is. And the best example is, I will give you two examples. Look at me. Two examples. Number one, they got the blood money in accidental death. Or the diyat of qatul khata. And number two, al-qusam. Yes, in books of hadith, there is one chapter, Babul. Qusam. In fitting book, there is one chapter, Babul. Qusam. So anyhow, what is Qusam? And what is blood money? If somebody will kill someone for no reason, purposely, not accidentally, so there will be qisas. They're the only thing. They're the only thing. Jamhur said, qisas are diya if qisas is not diya. Imam Bukhari says, the Holy Quran says, there is mutiba alayhi mulka, qisas fil qatla. Yes, well, period. In qatla amat, there is no diyas. There will be badal surah, that is something else. There will be badal surah, that is something else, which is by mutual concept of both parties. But you cannot go directly on your own to blood money in case of qatl-e amad or qatl-e murder. That's what Imam said, rahmatullahi alayhi. But in qatl-e khata, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the blood money, al-diyatu wadiyatu musallamatu ila ahli. That there will be a diyat or blood money. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them that what few people used to do in qatl-e khata or accidental death or killing someone by mistake. So they said that your grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, was your chief. Who was the chief of Makkah? Abdul Muttalib. So from the very beginning, he put the compensation or the diya, 10 camels. But still, people were neglecting. They were not that much involved. He didn't do. So he increased it to 20, then to 30. But when the number arrived at 100, then the people stopped way too much. Where from you can find 100 camel? It means a lot. What is the price of camel now? One camel? Tell me how much? Huh? Huh? More than that. Yes, because we buy one cow there for slaughtering for 1,200 in California. You are living in good place here in California. Yes. So anyhow, there will be $2,000 per camel or more than that. So 100, that is $200,000. Where you will find it? Yes, even the bank and the financial institution will not finance you. Then you can somehow how it can we can finance you. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers in Islam, look at me. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِذَنْ هُوَ شَرِيَعَةِ That is my law. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, my law, it means endorsed by me and not by me. وَمَيَنْتِ فَوَلِ الْحَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَقِيُّهَا Whatever he was doing, it was based on what he. So endorsed by Allah subhanahu, because that custom was good. That was a perfect custom. Aar Qusama. If a dead body is found in a locality, yes, and it was proven that he did not die natural death, but somebody killed him. Somebody killed him. Who is the killer? Somebody killed him, so somebody is there. Let's find out. So the family would be questioned by the court of law, whom you have a doubt on in the locality. So if they mention a few people, so the police will take them into custody and they will question them. They will question them. If they admit, then the case will be other way around, killing case. If they will not, so all these people, they would be given an oath in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did later on the same locality of Yahud, a Muslim got killed there. Nobody was aware of who killed him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he brought them. And there were 50 people they mentioned. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave all of them an oath in the name of Allah. And the warning of the oath was that we have not to kill him, nor we conspired against him, nor we know who killed him. Three things. We are not a part of conspiracy, not practical killer, nor we know that who killed him. So when this procedure was done, so Prophet told them, now you have to pay the blood money. Now you have to pay the. So they say, Ya Rasulullah, Qad halafna billah. Qad halafna billah. We took an oath in the name of Allah, and we are paying the blood money as well. Rasulullah said, that your oath rescued you from execution. But this was a human. He was not a donkey. He was not a dog. This was a human. He got killed in your locality. So you have to pay the blood money to the family. So this was actually the practice of Abdul Muttalib in his time in Al Jazeera. So Rasulullah endorsed that. That's number one. Number two, their custom, which was totally bad. Like idol worship. So idol worship, there was no any room for information. Let only 1 hour you can do it. Or 15 minutes you can do it. Not you cannot do it even for 1 single minute, that is shirk. So Prophet demolished it from day one, that there is no room of idol worshiping and shirk in my name. And the third category was they got partially good and partially bad, like marriages. You heard from ulama, from Sheikh Nikali, from Brother Abdul Jabbar, from Qarishah, from Allah Raza Kazim, from other ulama, that the Arab before Rasulullah, they were married or not? They were doing marriages or not? Yes, they were doing, but they were doing it. They were doing, but they were doing. Why? Because there was no any number fixed. A powerful man, he had all the right to have as many wives as he wants. A powerful man, he had all the right to grab any girl and to claim her that this will be my wife. And even the family did not have any right to object to, because he was a powerful, he was a strong man. And they were not giving them any due status and due right. They were using them just like tissue papers and throwing them away. No any social status, no any financial status, no any right, nothing like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he reformed this custom. First of all, he made it clear that women are human like you. Bahadur and Bahadur, Mutasabina Fima Bayanaka Imam Sayyidina Imam Hani goes this. Yes? Sayyidi Jalalain, wherever you say Bahadur and Bahadur. So, and I like these two Mufassirin regarding this specific word of Quran. Bahadur and Bahadur, because if you were translating word by word, so you said, some of you are from some of you. So, what it means, the people say, what? Some of you are from you. Yes? So, they have given the specific technical translation to Bahadur and Bahadur. Mutasabina Fima Bayanaka. That you are equal to one another. Now, a major man who is too short, and a tall one who is 8 feet tall, like Shaquille O'Neal. You know Shaquille O'Neal? You don't know? Yeah. I thought you are not fond of basketball. Yeah, we the Californian, we are addicted to basketball. Yeah? Huh? That is good, yeah. So why do you not know Shaquille O'Neal? Yes, you do know it. So anyhow, he's a tall man. He's a man, and the main man is also a man. A white is a man, and a black one, and a brown one. Yes, man in the meaning of human. So in the same way, a male person is human, and a female, she is human as well. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it clear. Then after that, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that now, when she is a human as well, so she has the human rights. She has the human rights. I have written a book in English, and Brother Darjan, he compiled it, but that is not printed yet. Islam, Objections and Answers. That's a big book, Islam, Objections and Answers. And there is a specific chapter of human rights and woman rights. Specific, that what Islam says about women, and what Islam says about humans.
I said, from the very beginning, I mentioned here,
when people were not human in sense.
So this was Islam and Prophet of Islam who introduced humanity to them.
That's what humanity means. What human is? People became human because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Otherwise, who can be? Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
Who?
Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Once he was sitting in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he was looking at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, what a big mercy of Allah you are, O the Messenger of Allah. Look at my Bible. What a great mercy of Allah you are, O the Messenger of Allah. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at the Prophet and something is roaming around his brain. That's why he said something. If suddenly somebody says, without any connection to something, like, what's going on? So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah Ya'ud, what's going on? So he said, Kunna Dullahan.
Kunna.
We were lost people. We were lost people. We were not human. We were lost people. We became human because of him. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he himself narrated, Kunna na'bud al-ashjar wal-ahjar wal-hayawanat wal-tuyur wa kullu ma narahu hasna. That anything which amazed us, we started worshipping it, that is in God. There is a beautiful tree, having a beautiful flower, we started, this is God. A beautiful rock and a stone, we started worshipping there. A good well of ocean, oh, this is very great, let's do it. A shining star, we started there. The moon, we started there. A hewan, a powerful one, and still, the Muslims are doing that. If somebody, we'll go to India and he will visit the mandir, their temples, so he will find different type of gods in shape of snakes. Yes? In shape of lions, in shape of other animals and birds, and they are worshipping them. So Sayyidina Umar said, Ya Rasulullah, we were doing all these. And he said, for different purposes. We had different type of gods and idols. My father was a business son, a businessman or trader in banks. So he used to take ships full of dates to Persia and to Rome, to all those areas. Export, import business of dates. Big businessman. He said that for the same purpose, he had made a statue of dates, eatable dates. He took out the stone and crushed it, and a sweet girl was sitting here in a corner of the house. Whenever he was taking early in the morning a ship towards Rome or Persia, he used to worship their God the whole night. They take the ship in peace. Yes, he gave me a lot of profit in this trip of mine. So Sayyidina Umar said, O the Messenger of Allah, one day I got hungry. I was alone at home. Mother was not there, looking for something to eat. Couldn't find anything. Rushed to the God.
Up to elbow.
Yes. You are washing it in wuzu up to elbow. Sayyidina Umar, he ate it up to elbow. Yes. He gave the same wuzu to the gun. Yes. But it was another type of wuzu up to the elbow. He said that when I came to my sense, hunger is gone. So he said, oh my God. فَتَذَكَّرْتُ غَزَبَ أَبِي. I recall my mind that my father, when he will come back, he will kill me. And what a man you are. You are God. You are the arm of God. فَتَذَكَّرْتُ غَزَبَ أَبِي. So as you know, that when a teenager is afraid of his father because he has done something wrong, so he is trying to take his mother on his side. Is that not? Mother is a good defense. That is not. Sometimes, not now, especially in America, there is no room for that. But back home, we are the male dominant culture. So there, yes, the sons and the daughters, they are taken to confidence who? The mother. And if the father will lose his temper and he will start beating, so the mother comes right in the middle. Sometimes the poor lady is getting beaten. But still, she is defending the son. She is defending the kid. She is defending the child. My dear respected brothers in Islam, anyhow, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He said, then what? So Sayyidina Umar said, I want to give my imam to help me out. Difficulty.
Mushkil Kusha. The mother was at that time. Mushkil Kusha.
So I found her in a house of my cousin. She was there in connection to some business or whatever. So I say, Ya Umma, Adri Dili, Ma, help me. She said, what's going on? I related the whole story that I have eaten a full arm of God. The Baba will come back, he will kill me. Yes, and it was expected because he was father of Umar.
Yes, gene works.
So as you know nature of Umar, so Sayyid could help me the nature of his father as well. So he said, Patasakkar to Azawa Abi. So I asked the help of my mom, for the help of my mom. She said, don't worry. Yes, making God and repairing God is not that much difficult thing. Yes, every day we are making God and destroying it and making another one, any one, because of a time bar. This God is not. There is time bar. We need a new one. So he said that my mom, she arranged some dates of that time, the same color. Yes, and she repaired the arm of dead God. Now Rasulullah listened to the story. He smiled. Yes, and he indicated to his skull. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like this. And he said, Ibn Khattab, awalam takum indakum waqul. At that time, you did not have aqal in your skull. When you were doing all these things, Jazallahu anna wa ansayat ummati umara khayran, radiyallahu anhu. May Allah bless him. What a beautiful answer. He said, Ya Rasulullah, kanat indana waqul, lakin lam takun hidayah. Aqal was there, sense was there. We were successful businessmen. You were. Mean somebody who does not have sense like me, I would not do anything about business because I am too much stupid in their business, in their field. But they were successful in business. So I said, Kana Pandana Wakul, we had the aqal, walakin lam takun hidayah, but the guidance was not there. And guidance, that is divine. Guidance, that is divine, that is revealed. So those who do not believe, I was referring to our friend and our, they are our close friends from the Pakistan and from Pakistan, Chinese. How developed they are? Yes? Now they are considered as what? Economical hub or economical superpower. They are controlling all the bazaars and markets everywhere. I was referring to that in Mecca and Medina, you will go out to the bazaar of Medina and Mecca, everything is made in China. Even here, everything is made in China. That's why our president is trying to make something in America also. Oh, to make something in America also, but here the labor, the price will go too much up. So anyhow, everything made in China. And now, the new news of last week is that they have built up what? Artificial human. What? Artificial human. And he will be a smart human. He will be thinking like human. And they say that he started functioning. He started functioning. So they are going too much ahead. It means they have the aqal. But they don't have the guidance. So they are eating the frogs, the snakes, the worms, the monkeys, the dogs. Just name it. Whatever. So I say, why? Aqal is with them. That's why they are controlling the whole world economically. But they do not have a Muhammad like that of ours. They have it, but when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide them to say La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, to come out of the filthy world into the human world. I do mention time and again that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala built up the structure of human, so he built it up from what? From the clay. From clay to sticky mud, salsalim min hawain masnoon, from the sulala of clean. From the solar line, nucleus of clean. And then when the people were getting born, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was sending the messengers. Why? Allah told them, I have put the capability and the ability in their nature. In their nature, I have made them man. Man in the meaning of person. I have made them man. You, the messenger, will go and make them you. I have made them man. You will go and make them human. So anybody
who is connected to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to what extent and what level? To that extent he is a human. So Sahaba they had perfect connection with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as I was telling you, that they did not know any difference of Sunan Adiyah and Sunan Ibadiyah. How does the Rahim Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That's how we saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an, you know him, the son of who? Son of Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an, and the muhaddiseen call him Muttabi' al-Sunnah. So our Sahaba were Muttabi' al-Sunnah. Our Sahaba. Can we think about the Sahabi that he didn't know a Sunnah and he was practicing otherwise purposely? Can you conceive it? They were not doing it. They were sacrificing their life for one single sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, once he was traveling somewhere, outside Medina and outskirts of Medina, there is a water fountain. Or there was a water fountain. It was very freezing cold. Nafi, the student of Abdullah ibn Umar, who was the teacher of whom? Imam Malik and Imam Hanifa both. And you have gone, alhamdulillah, most of you have gone to Medina and Munawwara. You visited the Makki cemetery. Yes, and you have visited the two graves close to one another, Imam Malik and Imam Nafi. So Imam Nafi, he was an African, but he was a great scholar, thanks to slavery of that time. Otherwise, slavery is not recommended by Islam. But at that time, the slavery gave something good, not something good, too much good to Islam. Because all these great Imams, mostly they are slaves. But Sahaba al-Bamlai al-Mahim, they taught them and trained them to such an extent that they became the leaders of the entire Ummah to the Day of Judgment. In one time, all the great Imam and the Fuqaha of every great city except Kufa. Because in Kufa there was Ibrahim Nakhai, Rahmatullahi Alayh. He was the only one who was Arab. Otherwise, Atta ibn Abi Rabah, Mujahid, Qatada, all these great Hassan Basri, Abdullah ibn Mubarak, they were from slave families. But what a great name. They were from slave families. All of them, they were slaves. Once, Ishaq ibn Malik, the Umayyad Caliph, he was along with his two sons there in Haram, making the tawaf. And that was crowded at that time. And at that time, this protocol was not taking place, that a king or a ruler is there. So the police is there and taking him to the Hajar Aswad and all the people too far. And then, anyhow, Fitrat is revolutionary. So this is revolution. But at that time, no such type arrangements were there for Khalifa, for Amir al-Mu'mineen. So Hisham ibn Abdul Malik, along with two princes, along with two sons, he was trying in every single round if he can approach Hajar al-Aswad to touch it. But crowd was that much that he was unable. And suddenly, an old white bearded man, black and dark complexion, curly hairs, big lips. He walked in, and when the people saw him, so all of them, they made a way for him towards Hajar al-Aswad, and they said, "Your Sheikh, Sheikh is here." So he went, he did lamas. Then, now the two sons of the Khalifa, Amir al-Mu'mineen, who was controlling three continents, he was not the Khalifa of a small world, he was controlling three continents. So they said, "Baba, what is this? You the Amir al-Mu'mineen, you couldn't touch it by Hajar al-Aswad once in seven rounds. And this black man, he is touching it in every single round. When he approaches Hajar al-Aswad, the people give him away, he goes forward, he touches it or kiss it, and then he is making another round." So it was amazing for them that you are the king. You are the Khalifa and the Amir al-Mu'mineen. This black man, for sure he will be a slave because he is black. That was a brutality at that time. So anyhow, when the tawaf was finished, so that black man, he came and he prayed his two rakah. Khalifa also came and stood behind him and he told his sons that they prayed two rakah. They prayed two rakah. After that, he was done. So Khalifa came forward. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. He saluted him, gave him a respect. And then he said,
Shaykh, how are you?
Alhamdulillah. He said, some wasiyah for me.
He said, ittaqillaha fi ra'iyatik. Have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding your ra'iyah. Have fear, deal them and treat them like your own kids. You are not father of your own kids only. You are the father of the whole ra'iyah. So think of them. And then he said that Imam or Sheikh, any help? He said, nothing. He said, I want to give you some hadiah. He said, but I don't want it. And I don't need it. I have my food. Now the two princes, they were looking at the black man there.
Yes.
And then suddenly, Hisham Abdul Malik, he called one of his worker or soldier or whatever, and made the announcement. That once again, renewal of the announcement of the Khalifa. That la yufti ahadun bi Makkah illa Ata ibn Abi Rabah. That in Makkah, this is not allowed for any alim to give fatwa. Authentic fatwa being endorsed by the state, that will be the fatwa of Ata ibn Abi Rabah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So now the two princes, they ask him, Baba, who is Ata ibn Abi Rabah? We want to see him. He said the same thing, man. All people know him. That this is Imam Ata ibn Abi Rabah, rahmatullahi alayhi. Imam Malik studied under him. Imam Abu Hanifa studied under him. When Imam was free from his tawaf or whatever, he used to sit in front of Ata ibn Abi Rabah, radiyallahu ta'ala an. He was a slave. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers in Islam, a few points in the end, and then I will make dua. And that is, I have recited a few ayat. Actually, Qarisan recited these ayat in the very beginning. Yes, so it came into my mind that can be recited. Even though I cannot explain all these ayat in 2, 3, 4 hours, but anyhow, only a brief of that. And that is, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا كَانَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ مِنْ حَرَجٍ فِيمَا فَرَضَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Exceptions are there. Certain rules are not applicable to the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In brief, I am telling you. Ma kana ala nabi, because source of law is Allah. When he allows someone to do something which is prohibited and forbidden, other way around. So that is allowed because it came from the source. Ma kana ala nabi min harajin fi ma faraz Allahu la. Sunnat Allahi fi alladhina khalaw min qabl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that the routine sunnah of Allah, he is doing sometimes certain things for his prophets and messengers. وَكَانَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ قَدْرًا مَقْدُورًا. That's a decreed amal, decided amal, being decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who are these people? الَّذِينَ يُبَلِّغُونَ رِسَالَةِ اللَّهِ وَيَخْشَوْنَهُ وَلَا يَخْشَوْنَ أَحَدًا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And those who have taken the responsibility. Now, we don't have any messenger. Is there any room for any messenger of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? No. Who will be doing the same job? Shaykh Mikail, Shaykh Abdul Jabbar, Mawlana Abdul Aziz, Qari said, or other ulama say, alhamdulillah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put these students for their job which was the job of the Anbiya alayhi salawatu wa taslima. That's what I said. My Shaykh rahmatullahi alayhi, he got killed 9-10 days before. One of the Sahib Rahmatullahi alayhi, a great muhaddis, and the Mu'tamim of Darul Haqqaniyah, the biggest ever madrasa all over Pakistan. Yes, he was teaching a hadith every year to 16, 17, 1800 students. In Darul Haqqaniyah, every year, in the final year, the students number is from 16 to 1800. And the entire number in Darul is from 7,000 to 8,000. And therefrom all the expenses are coming from you people. The Muslims in Pakistan and from all over the world, they are helping all these madaris. And that's what I said last year when I went for Dars there. So I said to the students, they give a due respect to Shaykh Samir Haq. I said, look, in this time, when the situation is very tight economically and financially, if somebody will have more than two kids, so I said, hey, this is the railway line in front of the madras. This is the railway line. So their guy is going to the railway line along with his wife and kids and throwing themselves in front of a train. Yeah, to run over them and to commit suicide because they don't have enough to eat. It happened. See,
Hyderabad. It happens.
So I said that you are saving 8,000 students.
Said, this man, he is trying to collect for you the tawarruat, the contribution from Muslims in one way or the other. He is providing you food 3 times a day. He is providing you the cut and the charpai. He is providing you the electric. He is providing you the gas. He is providing you the books. He is providing you the medicines even. I know that family personally, that he and his son, at night, if they come to know that one student is not feeling good. Yes, so one of them, he rushes and bring a doctor. If he has a student, he's not feeling good. So I said that, look, at this time, he is doing all day. He is brutally killed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him. And give him the darajat aliyah. But thanks to ulama that in such a situation, they control the situation. Otherwise, you have seen the janaza. My wife, when she saw it, she said, it looked like Arafat. Millions and millions of people gathered together. Yes, so I was very much happy that still the Muslims have iman and respect for ulama. It's good or not? Say it. So anyhow, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so last year when I was there, I gave my dars and then I said 2-3 days, someone said, some was laughing. He said that we in Pashto, we use for someone who is using smart tactics. So we say, you are very alani. What we said? That you are very alani. So he said that, Khalsa, you are very alani. I said, that you said few words, but do you know how difficult these words are? I said that, look, general public is also here. The ulama are also here. Ulama, all of them, they are awliyaullah, but they have to do only 2 things. Number one, come down from arsh to farsh and sit with the general public. Yes? Come and sit on ground. Don't fly in this space and don't think of you that I'm a cousin of Jibreel. Yeah, you are human. So just come down to the general public. And number two, control your desires. I said, ulama, they should not look at someone that he's riding Mercedes. So I will try to have Mercedes. He is living in a big castle. I will try to live in a big castle. That's not your identity. Your identity is how much you are committed to the services of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, for the Republic, I said in the end that you must do 2 things. Number one, don't miss your faraiz and wajibah. And number two, avoid anything haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of you a big reward. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma rabbana ahsina hukmatana fi umuri kulliha wajibna min fil dunya wa zabil akhirah. Rabbana hinna wa la tuhinna wa afirna wa la tusir alayna. You all the brothers, you listen to me very carefully. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and your families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the Muslims all over the world. And to generalize our dua, Allah bring peace to the entire world. And especially to this country of ours where you are living. Yes, every week something is happening somewhere and then the whole country is feeling fear that what is going on. Close to our houses, a guy came and he went to one place and he killed 13, 14 people and injured 30 people. And you do not know that how the people were in fear that what will be going and what will be happening. So Allah bring peace to the entire world. Allah bring peace to the entire world. Allah bring peace to the entire world. You have your needs and necessities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them their needs and necessities. You will be having difficulties. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove their difficulties. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khairi khalqi Muhammad wa alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in.
Qadi Fadullah Sahib, for your mashallah very live discourse and lecture on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of us enjoyed it and all of us hopefully have derived maximum of the benefit inshallah, and this will go a long way in our lives. And I request you, whenever you are coming to New York, say please let us know so that we can benefit from you fully inshallah. Now there's a break for dinner. You will go in the basement and there's a dinner inshallah. After the dinner, we have time up till 8 o'clock. So you can wait or you can go home and come back inshallah. So thank you very much. Jazakumullah khair.